Oh.
Hello, my name is Claire Vaudrin and I am a registered PhD student at the University of South Africa. Along with my colleague Kevin Mearns, we compiled an article on managing open rock art sites for tourism in the Central Ulkuslamba Drakensberg Park, KwaZulu-Natal, South Africa. To start off, I'd like to explain what rock art is. Rock art is from the later Stone Age and is a form of art that is irreplaceable, it's vulnerable, and it is a heritage and cultural resource dating of a tradition of 30,000 years old. It is humankind's earliest form of communication and is a way for our ancestors to represent the ways of their living lifestyles. Rock art is damaged through human impacts and natural impacts, and throughout this presentation, I will be discussing them. But a general consensus is conservation needs to be a priority for the conservation of rock art in South Africa. Rock art can further be divided into two categories: rock art paintings and rock engravings. Rock paintings are further divided into another two categories: fine line paintings and finger paintings, also known as the later whites. Finger line paintings are of more interest in the Drakensberg as they are dated from an earlier time and they have more detail. The artists of these paintings were the Bushmen, also known as the Sand. They were indigenous nomadic people that roamed the lands as hunters and gatherers. They decreased in their numbers as there was an increase in white farmers. And in the 1900s, the last survivors lived in the mountains, in overhangs and in shelters. Why did they paint? Traditions and their religions, portals to the spiritual world, and decorative and they were means of recorded lifestyles. The study area. Ukhuhlanga Drakensberg Park is a Zulu word meaning barrier of spears. It is a natural barrier between Lesotho and the province of KwaZulu-Natal, and it runs for 150 kilometers. What is unique about this, it is South Africa's first environmental and cultural world heritage site announced by UNESCO in November 2000, the cultural aspect being for the rock art paintings. The reason for the study. There has been plenty of research and documentation on the interpretation, the restoration, and archaeological importance of rock art and conservation. And currently, there is information and research being done on rock art deterioration and conservation methods. However, little has been done on the human impacts and the environmental management and conservation of rock art paintings in the Drakensberg, especially linking to tourism. Thus, wanted to look at the complexities of tourism in the Ukhuhlanga Drakensberg Park. The aim: to contribute to understanding the impacts of tourism on rock art sites by assessing their management related to the conservation of rock art paintings and sites in the central Drakensberg while investigating the role tourism plays sustainably. Objectives. The main objective is to look at three criteria, which I will discuss on the next slide. And these will look at factors such as deterioration, tourism, and the management. Then I'd like to investigate if tourism is an advantage or disadvantage to the conservation of rock art paintings, to assess the common and missing management at rock art sites, to assess the future environmental management and conservation methods and appropriate methods for each rock art site. The three site criteria that I was mentioning. Number one, deterioration. This is a category of natural impacts. Natural impacts include natural weathering, flaking, fading, dust, animals, nests, plant, lichen, and structural instability. Human impacts. This falls under two categories, such as general impacts and intentional impacts. Under general impacts, we have increase in moisture, dust, litter from the tourists, rock art research creates impacts, site construction and erosion of archaeological deposits. Intentional impacts include vandalism, graffiti, touching, wetting and collecting souvenirs from sites, chipping and the commodification of rock art. Criteria 2, tourism and development. Archaeotourism and rock art tourism is investigated at each site and region, the development of the region with tourism and the influences of this, the accessibility and accommodation of the developments in the area, and the commodification of rock art. The third criteria, environmental management and conservation. The current methods we looked at, compared to past and proposed methods, rock art and environmental legislation, laws and awareness and conservation were investigated. The methods for this study included photographs and collecting of brochures, looking at comments of visitors' books, interaction with staff, rock art tour guides, and tourists. A table method was used to compare the different sites, and a comparison was made with the photos, observation, and notes. General research was done on the history and the development, management, and conservation methods of the area. At each site, 8 factors were looked at. Evaluation at each site. These are the 8 factors. Number 1, camp area and rock art awareness. Number 2, en route to the site. Number 3, upon arrival at site. 4, rock art surface and paintings. 5, weathering and deterioration of the surface. 6, general and intentional human impacts. 7, tourism factors at the camp and rock art sites. And lastly, number 8, management methods at the site. The studies went along, consequences of tourism was discovered. Positive advantages: increase in rock art awareness, opportunity to see the rock art in its natural setting, and increase in rock art tourism and contributions to local communities and local infrastructure. Negative impacts: altering of the rock art sites, increase in probability of negative human impacts, vandalism and graffiti. Rock art deterioration in general. Another finding of the study was, some rock art sites that are not open to the public thus have negative reactions to the closure and thus have now negative impacts. The behavior tourists at rock art sites need to be monitored constantly. An undamaged site appears neglected and dirty and is more likely thus than to be intentionally damaged by humans, while managed sites that are clean and consist of conservation interventions that display the importance of the site gain more respect and are less likely to suffer from human damage. In this table, you can see common managed methods and common missing management methods. Under common management methods, we have entrance fee to visit. These tours are conducted by rock art guides at certain times. Rock art sites are fenced or the general area. Sense of direction of flow at each rock art site with a viewing area. There's a parking area, also a dustbin found at a distance from the rock art site. The missing management methods. Better advertising of the rock art, guided tours needed, better provided of necessary information at the local rock art site's camp areas, need for pamphlets on the specific rock art sites, pamphlets on the general and other rock art sites in the Drakensberg, more viewing space, barriers to prevent touching of the art. And lastly, guides actually need more training. The unexpected findings. Archaeological research is destructive. Research equipment at sites were not signed or discussed by the guides. At the camps, little or no intentions of information and face-to-face interaction about the rock art and the sites were made. No visitor books of the rock art sites or pamphlets. And rock art guides need more information and knowledge on the sites, as well as guides actually touch the art, which is not appropriate. Recommendations. We recommend that pamphlets and more information on awareness at the camps and interpretive displays and information is needed. Better signage on the rock art protection and the equity that is needed at the sites. And better direction flow at the sites, viewing area space and ground surface management. Also, area needs to be fenced, no camping in sites, visitors' books needs to be done, good condition of the paths to the site is necessary, and training of guides, barriers at open sites to prevent visitors touching, and the monitoring of visitors is highly recommended. Thus, just to conclude the article and the research, the sand paintings of today are the voices of the sand people. Management and conservation is the future of the rock art. To many, tourism being an advantage or disadvantage to the conservation of rock art will forever remain an indecisive and debatable issue. A way must be found to create awareness and to conserve these magnificent paintings, while at the same time ensuring that the sand will be part of our history for future generations to enjoy, with or without tourism being involved. Thank you very much. Bye.